We always talk about how to close more sales, but we never talk about where to close the sale. Today we're going to talk about the best places to close a sale. And it's not what you think. The three best places to close a sale. Place number one, over the phone, where you're the most comfortable. I used to get invited to a lot of like business luncheons and dinners and meet with different people. And I would always spend a lot of time. We get ready, you go there and you talk and then no business is done, right? You waste a lot of time. How many of you have done this before? Comment below, right? What happens, right? You drive all the way an hour, you park the car, you sit down with them, you have lunch, and then did you close that sale? So the best place to close a sale is over the phone. I've closed millions and millions and millions of dollars of sales just over the telephone. Doesn't need to get fancy, right? Yes, sometimes you do need to meet face to face, but chances are you can get it done over the phone. I always ask someone, if they say, Dan, I would love to do business, but I would like to have lunch. I always set the expectation. Okay, so Mr. Prospect, what is gonna happen during lunch, right? Tell me what exactly are your expectations. Well, they would say something like, well, I'd love to tell you a little bit about my business, what I'm looking for. Well, we can get that done over the phone, right? Let's talk about it over the phone before we even meet face to face to see if there's even a need to meet face to face. So, over the phone, best place to close a sale. The second best place to close a sale is in your own environment. I'm talking about your office, your home, or at the very least, an environment that you are familiar with. Have them come to you instead of you going to them. Why? Because one of the biggest mistakes that you can make as a closer, as a sales professional, is what? Being too attached to the sale. So when you have to go somewhere, you're getting all ready and you drive all the way there, you park and you meet and you wait for the receptionist, and then finally you go into the boardroom and then you are waiting nervously for the prospect to come in. Guess what? That puts you in a very, very defensive position. And it's very easy for you to get emotionally attached to the sale because you've invested so much time and effort just being there. You don't want to lose the sale. You don't have any walk away power. You don't want to do that as a closer. So have them come to you where you are comfortable and you have back-to-back appointments. So then you know what, if this sale doesn't close, this deal is not closed, that's okay. You have another appointment coming up in the next 5 minutes. And you know the next person is coming in. So back to back, then you're not emotionally attached. You can be very, very logical, right? You're not attached to the sale. So have them come to you. Remember, when you go to them, you're the salesperson. When they come to you, you are the expert. The third best place to close a sale, and that is in a high-end environment. True story, when I was in Hong Kong, I was actually eating at KFC, having a little chicken, right? A few pieces of chicken. Right behind me, there was a guy pitching a multi-million dollar real estate deal in Hong Kong at KFC, okay? And I could sense, I could hear the conversation. The prospects were having so much resistance. Like, why the hell are we even meeting at KFC, right? So meet your prospect at a high-end environment. Now, even when I had no money, I noticed the difference in terms of when I meet someone at McDonald's or when I meet a potential client at a low-end coffee shop. Those deals I couldn't close. The minute I switched to a five-star hotel in an environment, and I had no money, I would just meet them in lobby. So don't give me the excuse of, I need money to do that. No, don't need money to do this. You need to be resourceful. So I was just meeting with them at the hotel lobby. And I noticed I closed more deals. And the prospects was also more receptive to what I have to say. Of course, you have to look sharp, dress for success. So those are the three places that I believe that you need to be in if you want to close more sales. But what if you don't know what to say and how to say it? Exactly what words and what lines you need to use to close more sales. I put together something very, very special for all my fans around the world. I call that the perfect closing script. Click the link here if you want a copy of that. I'm gonna give you the exact lines. What do you need to say? What words do you need to understand and master if you want to close more sales? So click the link and get your copy today. Perfect closing script. Exactly what you need to close more sales right now.